Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to know different types of CPU organization, and we'll try to understand about general register CPU organization. So most of the computers come under three categories of organization, CPU organizations. They are single accumulator CPU organization, general register CPU organization, and stack CPU organization. So far in our previous sections, where we have discussed about basic computer organization and microprogrammed control, we have understood about a single accumulator CPU organization. So what this single accumulator CPU organization, we'll just try to have a brief introduction of this, as the concepts related to the single accumulator CPU organization has already been discussed in our previous classes. So what is this single accumulator CPU organization is? So all the operations, whatever the operations that we perform on the computer, will be done based upon the accumulator. For example, if we want to add two numbers on a single accumulator CPU organization, how the addition can be done is, first we have to load the value. For example, the two numbers are 2 plus 3 we would like to add. First, what we have to do is, first we have to load the value to any of the operand onto the accumulator, and then we have to load this. After loading the value onto the accumulator, we have to load the next operand onto the data register, and after that we have to perform the addition operation on ALU. So this is what we call it as a single accumulator CPU organization, where all the operations that are performed on the computer are based upon the accumulator. So this is how the organization of the single accumulator CPU organization will be. The other kind of the second type of computer organization is general register CPU organization. So what this general register CPU organization is, so in this organization, so this is the block diagram for general register CPU organization. In the general register CPU organization, we are going to have a set of registers. So in order to perform an operation on this general register CPU organization, so we can use any of the registers. As we have seen that in the single accumulator CPU organization, any operation has to be done based upon the accumulator. But here in the general register CPU organization, we are going to have set of registers, and an operation to be performed on this organization, we can use, if we want to perform an operation, we can use any of these registers, and the resultant value can be stored on any of these registers. So this kind of organization is what we call it, this kind of CPU organization is what we call it as general register CPU organization. And this is the block diagram for the general register CPU organization, and how this is going to perform the operations. So all this is what we call it as register set, and these multiplexers are used to transfer the data from registers to the accumulator, and the values that we are going to obtain as the output from the arithmetic logic unit ALU will get transferred onto the registers by using this decoder. So this decoder is the decoder which selects one of the registers. The output that we are going to get from the arithmetic logic unit, if we want to store that output onto the registers, then we can select one of the registers, and the output will get stored onto these registers. And these multiplexers are used, so by using the select lines of these multiplexers, it is select A, multiplexer A, multiplexer B. By using the select lines of these multiplexers, we are going to select one of the registers, and the data on these registers will get transferred onto the arithmetic logic unit. Similarly, by using the select lines of B, all these registers are also connected to this multiplexer B, and based upon the select B, SELB, the select lines of this multiplexer, we are going to select one of the registers, and the content of these registers will get transferred through this multiplexer onto the arithmetic logic unit. And these are the select lines for OPR. So what this OPR is? The OPR means it is operation code. So what this operation code is, we are having 5 operation select lines. With that we can perform 32 different types of operations on this computer. 5 select lines means 32 different types of operations can be performed. So by giving these select lines with a certain value, with a certain value, with 5 bits, we are going to perform that kind of, so the micro operation like addition, subtraction, multiplication, so whatever the operations that we have, transfer the value onto the A, transfer the value into into the register. So these are the operations that needs to be performed. So this computer with 5 input lines, operation select lines, this arithmetic logic unit can perform 32 different kinds of operations. In order to select the operation, we have to give this OPR. Okay, so now for example, if you want to do the same addition operation on this CPU, general register CPU organization, how that operation can be done? For example, that operation can be done, 2 plus 3 can be done by selecting R2 register. So R2 register, we are going to select R2 register with the select lines provided with 001 or it is going to be 010. 010, by giving the select lines A with 010, R2 register will get selected and the value stored in the R2 is 2. And similarly, if you want to select R3 will get selected by 011 provided to select line B provided with 011. With that, R3 register will get selected and the content of R3 will get transferred onto this arithmetic logic unit. Here R3 data is there and here R2 data is there. And for example, if the addition operation is having a code of 00010, so this is the code for addition. By providing this code to this OPR input lines, operation input lines, we are going to perform R2 plus R3 will get performed. So here it is there in R2 and it is there in R3 and the resultant we would like to store on R1. So now what we are going to do is select D. So to this select line D, we have to give R1's register code. For example, if the R1's register code is 001, so by providing 001 on this select line 1, so this one is going to get connected to this R1. So the output of this decoder, 3x8 decoder, will get connected to R1 and the load of this R1 will get activated. So the load of this R1 activated means the value of 2 plus 3, 5 will get stored onto R1. So this is how the operations are performed on the general register organization. And we are having 7 registers. For that we are having 7 lines. Here also we are having 7 lines. One line is external input. If you want to provide an external input, that can be provided with this input, so that can be transferred onto arithmetic logic unit. And this is the control word for this kind of for this general register operation, so the general register organization. So what this control word consists of is select line A value, select line B value, select line D value and operation value. With this select, with this control word and based according to the requirements according to the requirements of the operations, those select lines will get activated and with that the data will get transferred onto the arithmetic logic unit and it will get transferred onto the corresponding registers. The output will get transferred onto the corresponding operations and this arithmetic logic is provided with the circuitry in such a way so that 32 operations can be performed. Okay, so this is the general register CPU organization. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. In the next video we will try to understand about stack CPU organization. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.